Welcome to the beautiful Styrian Mountains for another chapter in the story of the Austrian Grand Prix. The Spielberg circuit then is situated 700 meters above sea level, with just 10 corners making up one of the shortest laps of the season. One time around here is a distance of 2.6 miles, with the best overtaking chances into turn 1 or the tight uphill turn 3. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he starts from pole position. And Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Joker, Norris, Daniel Ricciardo, and Zhou, Leclerc, Gasly, Sainz, and Yuki Tsunoda, Vettel, Stroll, Esteban Ocon, and Latifi, Russell, Perez, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Callum Ilott, Mick Schumacher, and Nikita Mazepin. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
We can now use DRS. DRS now available.
Brilliant maneuver. Two places at once. Green flag. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Got that, confirmed. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums.
Valtteri is in the pits. We want to pit this lap, so push now. Release, release. Look after these tires now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Our gap behind is 2.7 seconds. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining.
Valtteri's giving it everything. He's just put in the fastest lap of the race. The fastest lap at this point in time is a 1 minute 2.4. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Fantastic. You've won the Grand Prix.
So, another fantastic victory for Red Bull today. Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today. What set them apart from the rest?
Well, I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on the track was today, speed. I know it sounds like an obvious thing to say, Crofty, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everyone at the team. Despite the best efforts of our championship leader, that lead has taken a bit of a knock today. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Anthony Davidson, who do you pick?
Well, Crofty, Daniel Ricciardo would have to be my driver of the day. It's less about what he did right, but how little he did wrong. Perfect driving.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Red Bull pulled further ahead in the standings. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
Great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts. How good does it feel to have both cars in your team take the top spots? Things are looking up after last week, aren't they? Do you have any comments about this team? Your teammate is up on the podium today. This is a great thing for the team, isn't it? Appreciate your time.
The contract renewal window has opened. We can try and renegotiate for a better deal with our current team or approach someone else. Great. They're happy to enter into negotiations with us.
I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.